All right, here we are, down to one final tier to complete for 27 gold and 27,000 racing dollars. Tier 18, we got Hunter, Speed Snap, and Cup. So we'll start out with the Hunter using the Ford Falcon. Let's see, at Richmond International Raceway. I haven't raced at Richmond in a long time. Of course, we get the Navy jet fly over here. Pretty awesome. It's one of the coolest intro screens there is in this game, at least I think. All right, so I think the target distance was 15 meters in front of Sylvia. Of course, Richmond, one of the smallest, shortest track in Real Racing 3, just that tri-oval shape. So we got three corners, I suppose, very wide corners, because it's obviously a NASCAR track. So there we go, pretty easily taken over. Let's see how far ahead. Yeah, that looks pretty good. There we go. Win by 41 meters ahead, so pretty good. I thought we used to get the jet flyover on this after race screen as well. Unless I missed it. I don't think I saw it. I don't think it was there. Oh well, so much for that. But anywho, the second place, yeah, 15 meters was the second and third place. So, all right, good enough. That does put the car ever so slightly in red, but considering that my car is fully upgraded, I think I should be able to complete the rest of the series without too much trouble. But here's the one down, and of course two more to go. So up next we've got Speed Snap at another NASCAR track. This time Daytona is the next destination here, and it's going to be at the motorcycle course. So where is this Speed Snap taking place? Is that the interior section or is it on the exterior section? I cannot keep those straight. I know one of them have the Speed Snap checkpoint at the outer rim, and this one looks like it's in the interior section after you make the first entry into the interior section of the track. Yep, so that's the Speed Snap for the motorcycle course. There we go. It's all about how you handle this corner, but considering my car's upgrade status, this should be easy. All right, so nice and easy. Let's see. Yeah, this Holden v Ford bonus series. All 18 tiers using two fully upgraded cars. Went by pretty quickly. I was able to close this out. I haven't closed it completely out yet, but you know, gotten to probably like what 97% completion at this point, because I only have one final cup race remain. That short Speed Snap does not really take up much of a service bars there, so that's always nice. So here is second gold trophy down, leaving me with just one final gold trophy to complete for that cup race at Melbourne. Of course, requires PR63. So 97% complete, as I was saying. All right, so for 27 gold and 27,000 racing dollars, here we go. We'll continue on with the car in ever so slightly red condition. Should not be slowing the car down too much, because you know it's like maybe 2 bars into red, maybe 2.5, but you know, really not enough to make a significant difference in cup races. If it's like speed record or speed snap or something that deals with the speed, then yes, every bit will make a big difference. But with the events like cup race, typically we can overcome those. So it's going to be a 5-lapper for this final race at Melbourne. So since we have 5 laps, but I don't really need to train the bots here, so we'll overtake once everybody hugs the corner on the inside. We'll overtake on the outside when it's open on one side, but when they close it out like that, there's not room for me to maneuver, is there? Okay, under the bridge. Alright. Alright, up to 9th place. 8-7. Not many more cars to overtake here as we head into this later half of the corner. This is the last sector of the Melbourne, of course. 4th place and the final chicane. Come out in 3rd place, so finishing the lap 1 in 3rd place. There's 2 more to overtake. We'll be homebound free, so a little bit tighter since we didn't have as much traffic to worry about. Still getting a little caught up in that behind the leader there. Alright, but once the circuit does open up a little bit, we can overtake without too much trouble. So yeah, get to the first place midway through the lap, the second lap here. On home from here on out. So 3 more laps to complete. I don't expect this to pose too much trouble at this point. Since we can take it almost all up. I was gonna say take it like time trial, but not if we're slamming into these corners and the walls. Yeah, I thought I missed a breaking point there. Getting sloppy. Right, that was the sector number, or the second checkpoint. So, enter the final sector of Melbourne. Let's see, 40, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54 second. The lap that is pretty much the open lap there without any opponent. So let's see the rate these bots are going. I wonder if I'm going to start up. Yep, I was going to say I was going to start lapping some of these guys, and there we are. And okay, I missed that. That's like the exact same spot I missed last time. Apparently, I cannot. I don't know how to break there. I should remember that these cars don't have much of a brakes. As I was saying, I need to start braking earlier into some of those larger corners. Carrying quite a bit of speed, speeding up quite a bit of speed. This first corner, or first, corner is pretty fast, but maybe it's large enough of an arc that we can take a bit more speed. But I know I take, I think I go a bit faster there. Let's see the final time. Yeah, this is gonna be, well, was there, I think there was maybe one lap, either lap one or lap two, that I actually managed to take that corner without messing it up like that. But yeah, like 4 out of 5 times I messed that one up, so this goes on to show. Anyway, that does conclude this final race for this bonus series, Holden versus Ford. It looks like Ford gets to take the final gold trophy here. Not because it's necessarily a better car, but it just, you know, happened to line up that way. Alright, so 4 minutes and 55 seconds is the total race time, with a best lap time of 54 seconds, and it looks like the opponents are averaging around minute 4, minute 5. So, alright, so get the car serviced, since we're more or less done with this series for good. Come next version, this series is going to be gone, so if you haven't completed yet, get going. In the meantime, I've got some gold to collect here for my final gold trophy. So yes, 27 gold plus 27,000 racing dollars for the Supercars Holden versus Ford series. So that's for 2016 version Supercars. So yeah, the 18 tier bonus series for 45 gold trophies you're gonna need, plus 2 time trials, so that's 47 in total for 2016. So that concludes 2016 version, and we'll continue on with a 2017 version. So we'll see you there. Take care.